All complex models begin as relatively simple shapes. So how did we get from this basic building block to this screwdriver handle? If we ignore the fillets, this is basically a cylinder with a series of extruded cuts or indentations. At some point, we expect to be using a circular pattern. Let's focus on one indentation and the area surrounding it. This form will serve as the basic building block or the seed for the pattern feature. Let's simplify this further and use this as our starting point. This is just a simple cuboid with a rectangular extruded cut. Obviously, if we do a circular pattern using this, we will not get a cylindrical surface. We need to replace the top face of the cuboid. We also want to replace the top face of the extruded cut. Start a sketch on this face and create two arcs. Make these two arcs concentric with each other. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Extrude, and extrude these two surfaces. Activate the Solid tab, go to Modify, Replace Face. For Source Faces, select the original flat surface of the cuboid. For Target Faces, select this curved surface. Confirm the operation and hide the surface. You can see that the top face of the solid is now curved. Do the same for the top face of the indentation. Let's take a look at the seed again. There is a smooth curved transition from the top surface to the bottom surface of the cut. We shall use a lofted surface to achieve that. Let's clean up this model by removing some of the unwanted surfaces. Activate the Surface tab, select these two surfaces, and hit the Delete key. The surfaces are removed and the solid body turns into a surface body. Let's create a root surface with this edge to act as a helping face during the loft. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Root. Uncheck the Chain Selection option and select this edge as the profile. For Type, select Normal. This will produce a surface normal to this face. Extend the surface slightly. Go to Create, Loft. Click on these two edges as the profiles. We want the loft to be tangent to the adjacent faces. Select the Tangent option and select Align to Surface. The loft would adjust itself to be tangent to this face and the previously created helping face. You can adjust the tangency weight to get the required look. Confirm the operation. Let's hide the helping face. Let's use the lofted surface to trim off the side surfaces of the cut. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the lofted surface as the trim tool. Next, we need to select the portion of the face to remove. In this case, it is actually hidden internally. Hover the cursor over that area and the portion will be highlighted. Select that and confirm the operation. Do a cross section to make sure that the trim has been done correctly. Repeat this for the other side. We have created a completely watertight surface. We need to stitch all the surfaces together and create a solid. Go to Modify, Stitch, select the faces. For operation, select New Body. After confirming the operation, a solid body is formed. activate the solid tab and use the offset face command to shift this face to achieve the required length. Before we do the circular pattern, let's construct an axis through the cylinder. Go to Create, Pattern, Circular Pattern. For pattern type, select Bodies and pick on the body. Select the axis and adjust the quantity accordingly. You can see that these V-cut grooves are simply a consequence of the circular pattern. To achieve this, you will have to do a bit of planning to adjust the width of the starting block so that the pattern does not give you the full cylinder. From here, combine the bodies. Fill up the interior. And create the rest of the handle.